and girls, I'm really excited today about today's video because we're going to go to a farm and we're going to visit milking cows, and the farmer's called Kirker, and there's also a big bull with the cows milking over 100 cows as a farmer, black and white freezing cows, and let's see all about it. Before that there, let's sing the song Never Let Go.
Very excited today with our video, and we're talking about milking cows, and everyone who likes cereal, likes a cup of tea or coffee, be thankful to the cows who provide the milk. And we're at a farm here and the cows are coming in to be milked. And they're so happy. So am I. Kirker the farmer's bringing the cows in. We're going to meet him. He's on his quad bike. Kirker. Kirker, good to see you. Thanks very much for coming. You're a happy farmer?
Yeah, I am, yeah.
What is a dairy farmer? What does it mean to milk cows?
So to milk cows, as you can see in the background, we have over 100 cows. And every day, especially this time of year, they'll be out to the field. They eat their grass, they drink loads of water. And basically, we take them into the milking parlour then, and then they're ready to milk out then.
How can you tell if a cow's healthy or happy?
One of the things is a cow with sore feet. If her feet are sore, she'll not milk as much. Another thing would be just looking at the cows, the condition of them. You can kind of generally tell if a cow, if her ears are perked up, you know, if they're drooped down. Again, that's another kind of wee telltale sign, but there'll be a few wee things. But one of the biggest things would be just if they're not milking as much in the parlour, that would be the biggest telltale sign. Something's annoying them or setting them, whether it's their feet or something else. Yeah.
So we've heard of a shepherd, how a shepherd cares for its sheep. Mm-hmm. As a farmer, would you care for your cows?
Yes, we would, yes.
Is that important?
Yeah, very important. So even when they're walking out of the milking parlour, we'd be looking at their feet, you know, and we have wee screens in the parlour and we'll see how much the cow's milking, how much is getting fed, and all that information is very important for us to know if the cow's been looked after properly.
Can the children see how you milk a cow?
Yes, of course.
Do you use your hands still?
No, we have a machine. So we have a machine that you just put onto the cow and it just milks her out just into a big tank that we can show you if you want.
Oh, absolutely. Can't wait for this one.
Okay.
Is this a swimming pool?
No, it's not, Colin, no. So this is our milk tank.
Yes.
And it holds 10,000 litres and it cools the milk right down till fridge temperature.
Uh-huh.
As the milk comes out of the cows, the same temperature as they are, so about 36 degrees.
And what do you do with it then once it comes in here?
So the big lorry will come into the yard, reverse up to here, and they'll clip onto there and they just suck it all out.
Every day or a couple of days?
Every 2 days.
That's great. So the cows come in, the cows fit in here?
No, they don't know.
Oh, that's it.
They'll go in the other way.
Oh, this is your entrance?
Yeah, it's my entrance, just. So we filter the milk, so there's two filters in here, so it filters it just in case any bits of dirt or anything gets into it. And this here is a plate cooler, and this cools the milk down a few degrees, a good lot actually, before it goes into the tank then. And then the tank will cool it right down till about fridge temperature.
Uh-huh. So very good, that's great. That's a big tank. So Kirker, this is where it all happens?
Yeah, this is where the magic happens, yeah.
How many cows are you milking at a time?
So we're able to milk 20, so there's 10 at each side.
Do you give them food? Is it like a, what do you give them, chocolate bars when they come in?
No, they get like a meal, so it's like a mixture of like different things. There'll be wheat in there, there'll be molasses mixed into it, just depending on whatever they want that for their diet.
Uh-huh.
Whether they're indoors in winter or outdoors in the summer, it'll change a wee bit.
So how many months would they be in, how many months were cows out?
So again, depending on the weather, they'll be in maybe from October till the start of April there, we had them out in the field, so good 5 months indoors at least, depending on the weather.
Yeah, and these are mommy cows. You have any daddy cows?
Yeah, I can't see him right now.
What's he called, a bull?
Yeah.
Is it safe for children to play with bulls?
No, never.
You can't trust a bull?
No, yeah. Never.
And a bull has attacked you before?
Yes, unfortunately, yeah.
Were you watching him whenever he came for you?
No.
You turned your back?
Yeah.
That's a lesson, boys and girls. Always be careful. Bulls are dangerous. Can cows be dangerous if they have a calf?
Very, very rarely, but again, if you're working with any kind of animal that's as big as these, if you're a small child, you always should be careful around them.
Uh-huh.
Because sometimes the cow could just swing around, you know, unintentionally and hit you. But yeah, sometimes they can be protective of their baby calves, but that's very rare for us. We don't find that too much.
Whenever you were at school, did you want to be a farmer when you grew up?
I didn't know, actually, no. I wanted to go into retail. I wanted to be a manager in either a homeware shop or maybe a clothes shop, but farming came back into my life just a few years ago, so I'm happy on the farm now though.
And you enjoy it outdoors?
I do, yeah, I love it outdoors. Yeah.
You don't wear a suit and shirt and tie when you're milking cows?
No, definitely not, no. No shirt and tie here.
You're a Christian, Kirker?
I am, yes.
Is that important in your life?
Yes, very important, yeah.
In what way?
Just knowing that I have, you know, God's love and that promise of, you know, eternity with Him, just by accepting Jesus into my heart, just having that reassurance in my life and for my family as well.
Do you have a favourite Bible verse?
It's Nehemiah 4:14, and the gist of it would be just the fight for your family, so that's your wife, your son, your daughters, and also not just them, but also in your community as well. So God wants you to do that. So that's kind of a big part of that for me in my life would be Boys Brigade and men's ministry, whereas I want to fight for men in the community and also want to fight and reach young people, especially boys and BB.
When you say the word fight, you don't mean physically?
No, not physically fight, no. No.
So literal meaning of the word.
Yeah.
Also, but being so busy at farming, what else do you do apart from milk cows on the farm?
So this time of year, we're getting ready for silage now, so ground's getting, you know, slurry on it. It's getting fertilizer on it to help it grow more. I noticed tonight I had a cow broke out. I have to fix fences. You know, there's loads of jobs to do, especially tractor jobs this time of year.
So you never sit up during the day with your feet up and go and have nothing else to do?
No, well, there's some paperwork, but not too much.
Would you encourage children at school to work hard in school?
Yes, definitely, yeah. Because even if you're not going to maybe go into a job, maybe needs a degree or anything, is still very valuable, especially in farming now. There is more paperwork than there used to be, and also the amount of technology in farms as well. Like, you need to, there is stuff you need to know.
So even we boys want to be farmers, they should go to school because they're going to have to learn to do paperwork and computer work.
A lot of boys I know went on the Green Mount, went as far as New Zealand to do, you know, more agricultural, you know, studies and things to get there. All very valuable. If you want to have, because farming nowadays is getting more and more difficult and harder. Uh-huh. So you really need to have your studies as well to embrace technology and to basically take on new methods of doing things as well.
And whenever you're farming, can you think about the Lord and your Christian life?
Yeah, mostly when I'm driving about in the tractor, just that free time, just you're maybe tiddling around a field, doing something a bit mundane or boring, and I'll just pray, you know, just in the tractor.
And do you ever have a bad day, or if anything ever go wrong?
Yeah, all the time.
Do you ever pray and ask God for help?
Yes, of course, yeah.
And can he help even on the farm?
He can, yeah, even if it's just calming down, just taking a minute to, you know, take it easy and not lose your head over something. You know, it breaks down, maybe the JCB's broke down or something, just asking God just to calm you down, just, it's not the end of the world, you know, you'll get it fixed in the end.
There's so many lessons just talking to Kirker on the farm. Even we talk to children, sometimes we get frustrated, we get angry, we get not knowing how to make good decisions. Even on a farm, the lessons are exactly the same, and God never changes. He specializes in helping a person in their daily life. Kirker, what breed are those cows?
So they're Holstein Friesian, so it's kind of like a pedigree of a cow. And they would probably be one of the best to milk then.
And if any boy or girls are watching one of milk cows when they grow up, would you recommend that?
Yeah, would, yeah. It is. It's great working outdoors and working with animals, yeah.
Yeah, be healthy. Okay, well, I'll keep you back. And next time I'm going to eat my cereal, I'll say thank you for that there.
Yeah, no problem at all. Better get back to work here.
Okay, thanks, Kirker.
No problem, thank you.
All right.
Whoa, really enjoyed that. Thank you, Kirker, so much for letting us see your cows and how the milking machine works and how the cows are milked morning and evening. Very, very interesting. Out in the grass in the summer and inside the winter. So boys and girls, when you're eating your cereal and drinking your milk, just be thankful for the farmers out there milking their cows to give us so much food and nourishment. Next thing, I've got peace like a river. Cows love water to drink. And they love to see the river, so they know there's water and the grass. All they need is the grass and water, and they'll give you the milk. Do you think it's amazing how a black and white cow eats green grass and gives white milk? Can you explain that? I can't. But God. Let's sing I've Got Peace Like a River. Thanks so much for watching today. Really enjoyed today, and thank you so much, and enjoy the rest of your day. Yeah, yeah.